السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الجزء بقى الثالث اللي هنبدأ فيه النهاردة هو في برضو من الإندوكراين and metabolic disorder. المرة دي بقى هنتكلم على الأدرينال جلاند. الأدرينال جلاند زي ما احنا شايفين بتتكون من ميدلا and كورتكس، والكورتكس نفسه بيتقسم لثلاث أجزاء اللي هو زونة جلوميريلوزا، زونة فاسيكولاتا، وزونة ريتيكولارس. الأدرينال جلاند related بالproduction of different agents important for human life like المينيرالوكورتيكويدز الدوستيرون and كورتيزون، الجلوكوكورتيكويدز كورتيزول and كورتيزون، الأندروجينز أستروجين and تستوستيرون هرمون، الكاتيكولامينز الإبينفرين and نورإبينفرين، the peptides somatostatin and substance B. This schematic presentation of the adrenal gland shows how, for example, here the renin angiotensin system by positive stimulation stimulate zona glomerulosa to secrete mineralocorticoids, mainly aldosterone. How the cortisol secreted from the cortex by negative feedback inhibition inhibit the pituitary adrenocorticotrophic hormone, which stimulate both zona fasciculata and zona reticularis to produce cortisol and androgen, and the, both of them, the androgen, testosterone, estradiol, and the cortisol by negative feedback inhibition inhibit the secretion of the adrenocorticotrophic hormone. This is mainly in the cortex of the adrenal gland. However, the medulla is related or correlated with the production of catecholamines, as we said, epinephrine and norepinephrine. There is hypersecretory cortisol diseases. Number one, Cushing syndrome. It is classified either adrenocorticotrophic hormone dependent or adrenocorticotrophic hormone independent. The adrenocorticotrophic hormone dependent is a result of excessive adrenocorticotrophic hormone secretion. And this could occur in the pituitary corticotroph adenoma, Cushing disease, or in the ectopic adrenocorticotrophic hormone syndrome, named extra-pituitary tumor. أما في حالة الأدرينوكورتيكوتروفيك independent, أدرينوكورتيكوتروفيك هرمون independent, it occurs as a result of excessive cortisol secretion or exogenous steroid. Like in case of unilateral adrenocortical tumors, bilateral adrenal hyperplasia or dysplasia, and exogenous steroid administration. How to diagnose hypersecretory disorder of the adrenal gland and how it is clinically presented? Presence of hypercortisolism through 24-hour urinary free cortisol concentration, which means increased hypercortisol secretion in a 24-hour urinary collection. To differentiate the etiology of this hypercortisol secretion, this is very difficult and beyond the scope of this chapter. It involves different tests for diagnosis of the disease. Among these laboratory examination, plasma adrenocorticotrophic concentration. It is normal or elevated in adrenocorticotrophic hormone dependent. Pituitary MRI, would differentiate the Cushing syndrome versus the ectopic adrenocorticotrophic syndrome. overnight dexamethasone suppression test, late night salivary cortisol level, 24-hour urinary free cortisol, and this is a test with low sensitivity. These tests are not our scope of interest for us as a pharmacist. It is not important for us to know the difference between these tests or how to carry out this test. The clinical presentation of the Cushing disease appears as central obesity, facial rounding, عنده منطقة البطن دي فيها obesity, وشه مدور, peripheral obesity, fat accumulation, myopathies, osteoporosis, back pain, compression fracture, abnormal glucose tolerance, or diabetes also, amenorrhea and hirsutism in women, lower abdominal pigmented stria, which red to purple, خطوط كده ملونة في منطقة البطن, hypertension, and this is the principal cause of morbidity and mortality in this disease. The therapy goal of the treatment for this condition is the reduction of morbidity and mortality by eliminating the cause, normalization of the biochemical changes when it's possible, reverse the clinical features. Therapeutics. If exogenous corticosteroid use is the cause, please discontinue or minimize use. If a tumor condition is the cause, the treatment of choice, as we said before, in all in the other different glands, is the surgical resection of the gland. The pharmacotherapy is usually reserved on the basis of the same criteria listed earlier for pituitary adenomas. The treatment of hypersecretory adrenal gland occurs by either inhibiting the adrenocorticotrophic hormone secretion, and this is through the use of the baziriotide, which is a somatostatin analog, block the ACTH secretion from pituitary, leading to decrease in the circulating cortisol concentration. It is dosed 0.6 to 0.9 milligram twice daily, subcutaneous injection. It has adverse effects like hyperglycemia, hypocorticalism, diarrhea, nausea, gallstones, headache, bradycardia. Before starting therapy with baziriotide, we should obtain an ECG, electrocardiogram, fasting plasma glucose, hemoglobin A1C, liver function test, and gallbladder ultrasonography. During therapy, we self-monitor the blood glucose value every week for first 2 to 3 months, periodically obtain liver function test 1 to 2 weeks after starting therapy, then monthly for 2 to 3 months, and then every 6 months. Repeat gallbladder ultrasonography at 6 to 12 months intervals. Cabergoline also could be used. Other mechanism of treatment is the inhibition of the cortisol synthesis, and this is achieved by the use of ketoconazole, which hinders the cortisol production by inhibiting 11 and 17 hydroxylase. These are enzymes involved in cortisol production. The dosing is initially 200 milligram twice daily by mouse, and maximal dose is 400 milligrams 3 times daily. The adverse effect of ketoconazole is the gynecomastia, abdominal discomfort, reversible hepatic transaminases elevation. Zamitotane, it also inhibits 11 hydroxylase, but also have some direct adrenolytic activity. Initial dose 500 to 1000 milligram per day by mouse, Maximal dose 9 to 12 gram per day. Its adverse effect, adrenocortical atrophy, and this can persist on discontinuation, and in severe cases may necessitate androgen and glucocorticoid replacement, anorexia, ataxia, abdominal discomfort, and lethargy. The etomidate, it is similar to ketoconazole in inhibiting 11-hydroxylase. It is dosed initially 0.03 mg per kg intravenously, followed by a 0.1 mg per kg per hour infusion, maximal 0.3 mg per kg per hour. The adverse effect, pain at injection site, nausea and vomiting, myoclonus, and psychosis. It is reserved for when rapid control of cortisol concentration is needed and oral therapy is problematic. This is very important. Etomidate used only in emergency, لما احنا عايزين نعمل rapid control للكورتيزول, and we cannot use oral therapy. Metirapone by compensionate use only. It hinders secretion of cortisol by blocking final step in cortisol synthesis by inhibiting 11-hydroxylase activity. Dosing initially 500 milligrams three times daily by mouse. Average dose in Cushing syndrome is around 2000 milligrams per day. It is about to 4000 milligrams in ectopic ACTH syndrome. Adverse effect, hypoadrenalism, hypertension, worsening of hirsutism and acne, headache, abdominal discomfort. The efficacy of the different treatment is measured by the control of symptoms and the normalization of the 24-hour urine-free cortisol concentration. Glucocorticoid replacement may be necessary if circulating cortisol is reduced to lower than physiologic concentration. يعني لو احنا بعد ما ادينا التريتمنت الفري كورتيزول قل, we should supplement glucocorticoid exogenously. Mifepristone for hyperglycemia is associated, hyperglycemia associated with endogenous Cushing syndrome, as we said, and the Cushing syndrome بيبقى معايا hyperglycemia. Mifepristone proposed to limit binding of cortisol and can reduce insulin requirement and improve clinical symptoms associated with hyperglycemia. Another disease condition related to the adrenal gland is the hyperaldosteronism, primary aldosteronism. It is classified either bilateral adrenal hyperplasia, and this represents 70% of disease condition, or aldosterone producing adenoma, and this is representing 30% of the cases. It is diagnosed by elevated plasma aldosterone renin ratio. Other features is the hypernatremia, hypokalemia, hypomagnesemia, and glucose intolerance. In certain cases, it could be asymptomatic, or it may be associated with hypertension, muscle weakness or fatigue, headache, polydipsia, and nocturnal polyuria. The therapeutics used, number one and the drug of choice, is the spironolactone. It competitively inhibits aldosterone biosynthesis. It is dosed initially 25 to 50 milligrams per day by mouse, maximal 400 milligrams per day. Its adverse effect is hyperkalemia, gynecomastia, and abdominal discomfort. Another choice is alprinone and amiloride are alternative to spironolactone. The hyposecretory adrenal disorder, which are classified either primary adrenal insufficiency, اللي هي named Addison disease. It is caused by autoimmune disorder or infection or infarction. It results in cortisol, aldosterone, and androgen deficiencies. And the secondary adrenal insufficiency, which may be due to exogenous steroid use, leading to chronic suppression. Even if it is, however, it is given orally, inhaled, intranasal, or topical administration, it could be due to surgery, trauma, infection, or infarction. It results in impaired androgen and cortisol production. The diagnosis and the clinical presentation, we focus here on the Addison disease, your primary condition. It is diagnosed by abnormal rapid cozentropin stimulation test. Cozentropin ده عبارة عن synthetic adrenocorticotrophic hormone. When it gives blunted increase in cortisol concentration, this suggests an adrenal insufficiency. Clinical presentation, it is associated with hyperpigmentation, ودي نتيجة للإليفيشن of the adrenocorticotrophic hormone concentration, weight loss, dehydration, hyponatremia, hyperkalemia, and elevated blood urea nitrogen. The therapeutics used, number one is the steroid replacement, replace the cortisol loss. How? By oral administration, and in the oral administration, we mimic normal cortisol production circadian rhythm, which means that we administer 2/3 of the need from steroids in the morning and 1/3 in the evening. The daily cortisol production in average patient is about 5 to 10 milligrams per meter square. We have the hydrocortisone, 15 milligram per day, cortisone acetate, 20 milligram per day, prednisone, 2.5 milligram per day, dexamethasone, 0.25 to 0.75 milligram per day, fludrocortisone, that replaces loss of mineralocorticoid, 0.05 to 0.2 milligram per day by mouse. Also, the dehydroepiandrosterone, 25 to 50 milligram per day, is beneficial for women with decreased libido and with low energy level because of androgen deficiency. The efficacy of the different agent is measured by symptom improvement. We should note that during stress or illness, the corticosteroid dose must be increased. The dose and route of administration depend on the level of stress to the body. This table shows the equivalence between the different glucocorticoids, cortisone, hydrocortisone, prednisone, and these doses are in milligrams. Here is a patient case for this part of the chapter. It discusses a 44-year-old man having high blood pressure. He has frequent headaches, increased thirst, fatigue. His urine-free cortisol is 45 microgram per 24 hour, and the normal is 20 to 90. Which means he is in the normal range. His plasma aldosterone renin ratio is 125, normally is less than 25. What condition is the most likely cause of this patient's uncontrolled hypertension? Is it Cushing syndrome? Is it Addison disease? Hyperprolactinemia? Or hyperaldosteronism? The answer is D, hyperaldosteronism. Why? Because the patient aldosterone renin ratio is elevated. He has high blood pressure. Cushing syndrome and the hyperaldosteronism can be the secondary causes of hypertension. The patient here, free 24-hour cortisol is normal, as I said, so it is not Cushing syndrome. Therefore, answer 4 is incorrect. Answer B is incorrect because Addison disease is a result of cortisol deficiency, not increase in cortisol, and is not associated with hypertension. Answer C, hyperprolactinemia, is unlikely given the patient's presentation and his abnormal aldosteronin ratio. Many thanks. And any question